Several days ago, we posted the teardown and review videos of the 100W dual-port SuperVOOC charger. You can click the upper corner to check if you're interested. Today we got another SuperVOOC charger, but the output power is a little slower at 80W. The packaging design is almost identical to the 100W dual-port charger. Cut off the sealing sticker and open it up. The upper part is the charger itself, and the USB-C cable is placed under the charger and is covered with some documents. Take a close look at the charger first. Unlike the traditional USB-A SuperVOOC charger, it has a USB-C port. The slight hollows on two sides can facilitate the user to pull it out or plug it in. All specs info is printed under the fixed input prongs. Model is VCB8HBCH. Like the 100W charger, it has different upper power at different input voltages. It can reach 80W output at an input of 200 to 240 volts, and it only reaches 66W output at an input of 100 to 120 volts. The size of the charger is about 48 by 29 by 53.5mm. This charger is only 92 grams. After adding the cable, the total weight is about 123 grams. Our chargelet power ZKM003C shows it supports VOOC, SuperVOOC, and PD3.0 protocols. And it also has 4 fixed PDOs of 5V, 9V, 12V, 15V, 3A, and a set of PPS. So it can be compatible with 45W PD protocol. The red charging cable inside the box can support up to 6.5A, but it doesn't adopt a full pin design. And the cable length is about 1 meter. The chargelet power ZKM003C shows it integrates an eMarker chip, but the data transmission speed is only USB 2.0. Next, let's go ahead and use the spudger to pry along the gap. We found the potting compound inside the module. The black and red wires are connected to the input prongs. Continue to cut off the plastic case. Here is the potting compound we just mentioned, improving the heat dissipation performance. All plugging components are on the front. The planar transformer is on the side. And the upper PCB of the USB-C port is insulated by a white plastic plate. Then it takes some time to clean up the PCB. Let's speed up. Okay, it's better to observe now. ChargeLab found it adopts QR flatback topology, and it does not have a PFC circuit. The current will be filtered by synchronous rectification circuit for output, and the upper voltage is controlled by the protocol chip. Next, let's introduce every single component. The input time delay fuse is from Better Electronics, 2.5A, 250 volts. The NTC Thermistor is from JOYIN, used to suppress the inrush current when plugged in. The common mode choke is next to the thermistor, insulated with heat-shrinkable tubing. The safety X2 Capacitor is from STE, 0.22 microfarad. The largest chip on the back is the bridge rectifier from Yangjie, 6A, 1000 volts. Those three electrolytic capacitors for input filtering are from Koshin, 400 volts, 33 microfarad for each, 99 microfarad in total. The differential mode choke is placed in the middle of those three capacitors. It adopts an I-shaped magnetic core. The mass control chip is from On Semiconductor, which is a high-frequency QR flatback controller. It integrates active X2 capacitor discharge and supports wide-range VCC power supply. The GaN IC for QR topology is from Navitas and adopts QFN 6x8 package. It integrates GaN FET, driver, and lossless current sampling circuit. Without an external sampling resistor, it can reduce cost and improve efficiency. This tiny capacitor is from AiShi, which powers the mass control chip, 100 volts, 4.7 microfarad. A planar transformer is soldered on the side of the PCBA module from Huntkey. Its magnetic core is insulated by a plastic case. Those two blue-white capacitors are connected in series to increase the within voltage from South HongMing. Here is the EL1019 optocoupler used to regulate the output voltage. Next, the synchronous rectification circuit. Its controller is from MPS, and the maximum operating frequency is 600 kHz. The synchronous rectifier is from Pingwei and adopts DFN 5x6 package. Those two solid capacitors for output filtering are from Polycap. This one is from RT series, the other one is from RS series. Both are 470 microfarad, 25 volts. The protocol chip is from Medtronic. It integrates programmable voltage and current loop control, and is also compatible with QR, ACF, LLC topology. The USB-C connector is fixed on the independent PCB. The red rubber gasket can be used for dustproof and waterproof. Well, that's all components of this 80W SUPERVOOC charger from OnePlus. Since it supports the 45W PD protocol, it can charge third-party PD devices. After taking it apart, we found it does not have a PFC circuit. The GaN IC and Planar transformer can make the charger even smaller. As the default charger of Oppo and OnePlus phones, its quality is comparable to third-party chargers from well-known brands. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!